Module 4, Part 2, Embed Power BI Content. Hello, I'm Peter Myers, and I will now demonstrate how to embed Power BI content in a web app. This demo has two parts. In the first part, I'll create and set up an ASP.NET Core MVC app. And in the second part, I'll embed the reports from my Sales Reports workspace. To create the web app, here in Visual Studio Code, I'll go ahead and open an existing folder. Then in the terminal, I'll create the MVC web app. Next, I need to add three packages. So first I add the Microsoft Identity Web. It's a set of ASP.NET Core libraries that simplifies adding authentication and authorization support to web apps. Next, I add the Power BI API. It provides service endpoints for embedding, administration, and user resources. Lastly, I add JSON.NET. Now in the Explorer pane, I expand the Views folder and the Shared folder and open the layout file. Here I'm going to perform a search and replace to replace any instances of sales reporting with the Tailspin Toys sales. Then on line 6, I just adjust the title element to show just the Tailspin Toys sales app title. I save and close the layout file. Next, I open the app settings file, and then I paste in some new sections, specifically Azure AD, Power BI, and the current user. So into the Azure AD, I'm going to copy-paste values from my settings, like the tenant ID, and the client ID. And then it's secret. Lastly, for Power BI settings, I then copy and paste in the workspace ID. This informs the application of the workspace that contains the content to embed. Now the third section for current user will be covered later with data permissions and row level security. So I go ahead and save and close the app settings. Now I go ahead and replace the default style sheet with a pre-developed one. That way the app will look respectable. So in the Explorer pane, I go ahead and expand the www root and the CSS folders. And then from a file resource that I've pre-developed, I just drag drop the site CSS and paste it over the top and confirm to replace. I then close that file. So before I embed any content, it's now time to test the app to see that all's in order. So on the run, I go ahead and create a launch.json file using .NET Core. I then close that file, and then I proceed to run the app. The web app opens in a new browser tab, and while there's no content to see, all looks good. So I'm now ready to continue the development of the app to embed Power BI reports. So I go ahead and close the web tab, return to Visual Studio Code, and stop the running of that app. Now it's time for the second part of the demo to embed Power BI reports. In the Explorer pane, I expand the Models folder. I then use the drag-drop technique to add a pre-developed file, embedded datasets, into that folder. This file contains a single class that comprises properties of a Power BI dataset. Let me go ahead and add a second file for embedded report. So now I have three files in the Models folder. Next, I will add the ViewModel class to the web app. So I create a new folder named ViewModels. I then add the workspace ViewModel pre-developed file into that folder. The file contains a single class that comprises properties describing the datasets and reports and the embed token, all in JSON. An object of this type will describe all reports and datasets for a workspace and the embed token required to embed the content in the app. It will be available client-side to support the embedding operations. Now I'm ready to add the service logic to create an access token and connect to the Power BI service to retrieve details of workspace artifacts and generate the embed token. So I create a new folder named Services. Then I create a file in that folder named Power BI API Service. I then paste into this file the namespace directives that will be required and the definition of a namespace. Within the namespace, I enter some code. Let me go ahead and select everything and format it. And what I've just added into the namespace are some member declarations and also a constructor. The constructor sets private members on how to connect and authenticate with Power BI. Beneath the constructor, I go ahead and add a new method. This method is the getAccessToken. Beneath that method, I then add another method. And this is the getPowerBIClient. And then beneath that method, I add an additional method. Now this method is to get reports embedding data. So to step through the logic, it connects to Power BI, it enumerates all reports within the workspace, retrieving their ID, name, and embed URL properties. It then enumerates all of the datasets in the workspace, again retrieving ID, name, and embed URL properties. It then generates the token request for the workspace, bundles those requests together, and generates the embed token. Finally, it returns the report embedding data to the caller. I then save and close the open files. Next, I configure the view which comprises div and script elements. Here in the home folder, I go ahead and use the drag drop technique to replace the index file. In this file, notice at line 1, the model directive allows accessing the embedding content that the controller passed to the view. In lines 6 to 18, div elements are used to display workspace artifacts. At line 22, you can see the embedding container, which will contain embedded Power BI content. At line 28, a reference to the Power BI client-side script. And then at lines 29 to 33, client-side variables that will be assigned embeddable content and the embed token. I'll go ahead and close that file. Next, I add client-side logic to generate nav links and embed reports in the Q&A experience. So I now use the drag-drop technique to drag the embed.js file into the JS folder of the www root folder. In this pre-developed report, at line 7, you can see a function to generate nav links for the reports and datasets. At line 39, there's a function to embed a report, noting the creation of the config object, and the final line using the embed method to embed in that div using the config object. Then at line 66, there's the function to embed the Q&A experience for a dataset, with its config object and again embedding into the div using that object. I close the embed file, and then I open the index file. Then at the very bottom of this file, beneath the second script element, I add a third script element. The view now has a reference to the client-side logic that I added previously. I save and close the file. I'm now ready to add the controller. So within the controllers folder, I open the home controller file. I go ahead and add a new namespace directive. And then in the home controller class, I remove some default code. So I remove the iLogger read-only member, and also the constructor. I then paste in a new member and a new constructor. With this logic adding a private member to store a reference to the Power BI service, and then beneath it the constructor that sets the private member. I then replace the index method, and then I go ahead and save and close the home controller file. I'm now ready to add dependency injection. So I go ahead and open up the startup file, and then I paste in two additional namespace directives. And then in the configure services method, I go ahead and add some new logic. I then save and close the startup file. Finally, I'm ready to test the app, so I press F5 to run. And then here in the navigation pane, I can see the two reports and the one dataset. So to open and embed a report, I simply click a report link. Here's the sales analysis report. Completely interactive. And I can also open the sales map report. When I click the sales analysis dataset, it opens the Q&A experience. I could select a suggested question, or I could enter my own. What were the average unit price by date year as a column chart? And there I go. I've completed the creation of a new web app and have embedded Power BI content.